Welcome back. In this video, I'm just going to show you very quickly how to quickly go through the room and scan your space. This couldn't be any more simple. The first thing that you want to know is how to properly hold your phone. The way you hold your phone is basically by having your elbows tucked in close to your side so you can firmly get a hold of your phone. Now, you want to lean back a little bit, and I'll tell you exactly why. Most often, it's very common to do this the same way you would take a picture of a panorama, something like that, where it's a vista point of this faraway landscape. In this case, because all the surfaces are, relatively speaking, much, much closer to us, we can't do that. You can't have your body be the axis. What you need to do is have the phone be the axis. So to do that, again, just have your elbows tucked in close to your side to keep a firm grip of the phone. I like to lean back a little bit, and I have my foot set out a little bit in front of me, and the phone is right over my toe. And what I do is just tap the button right here to get the scan going. I'll tilt it so that the circle is aligned with the dots. It'll scan the first position, and then I just rotate to the left. And what I'm doing is just kind of pivoting around my big toe or the ball of my foot. And there you have that. And just kind of keep going like this until I've done the complete 360. So as soon as I'm done, all that information gets processed into the complete panorama, and it uses Cortex to convert it into the 3D model. Now it's aligning it into the model. And next thing, once I see this pop in here, I'm just gonna go over to this corner over there, do the same thing again, followed by that corner and then that corner, and then I should be done. You don't wanna be too far into the corner. You wanna stay about 5 to 6 feet away from the edges and corners of the room. So keep your pattern of 4 scan positions in the room, more towards the center and not so close to the edges. All right, so I'm all done. As you saw on the screen, I did 5 scan positions for this room, only because in this case, I started with my first scan being right here instead of a little bit further into the corner. Now I'm gonna go ahead and mark this. So by marking, I mean indicate in the model where windows and mirrors are located. So to do that, I'll just press the markings button right over here. And I can zoom in a little bit. There's this really large mirror over here, and I would need to mark that. So I'll press the mirror marking button right there and just draw a mirror marking from one end to the other. I can move my model around, I can zoom in a little bit and grab the edges of that marking to make this a little bit more accurate. And that should really pretty much do it. I don't feel like I need to do anything else. Just mark that mirror, so I'll X out of that. And now I'm ready to upload. So to upload, I can very simply just press the upload button in the top right corner. If you're in the home screen and you have a list of a bunch of different models that you've already done, you can go here and just press the 3-dot menu there, and you have the upload option right here in the menu. Before we upload, however, I just wanted to bring your attention to the background of this application. Now, by default, it does use cell data, just like many other applications, and works in the background. If you don't have an unlimited plan, because these are relatively heavy files, you may want to turn cell data off for this application so that it only uploads when you're on Wi-Fi. In order to do that, it's very simple. Just go to the home screen. I'll hold down the application icon, press app info, and go to mobile data. And you can see that background data is activated. So I'll just switch that off. So I'll get out of there and go back into the app, press those 3 dots. And then press upload. And I can see that it's asking me to sign in because I haven't yet signed into my account. Directly from the Capture app, you can either sign in or sign up for an account if you don't already have one. In my case, I've already signed up for my free account, so I'll just go ahead and sign in here. I'll add my email and password. And now it's ready to upload. The very last step before uploading, you have the option of turning on face blurring, and this is an automated feature. So in my case, I really don't need that. There's nothing in here that is sensitive. And if there is something that I find later on, I can always manually blur it in Workshop, and we'll definitely cover that in video number 3. All that's left for me to do is press the upload button and we're all done. Now let's go ahead and head on over to video number 3, where I will show you what to do with matter tags, blurring, highlight reel, everything you need to know in Workshop to get it perfectly set up.